Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Satim Vyasam
Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam
Tato Jayamudirayat
Tato Jayamudirayat
Nasta Praeshu Vapadreshu
Nasta Vayesha Vatrishu
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke
Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtaki
Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtaki.
We're reading the prayers by Queen Kunti from the Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 8. And this evening, we're reading text number 29.
今天我们要继续来学习昆蒂王后的祈祷系列的讲座。今天我们要进行的是第一篇《舍利弗迦瓦坛》第一篇第八章的第二十九诗节。
Naveda kaschid bhagavans chikirsitam
Naveda kaschid bhagavans chikirsitam
Naveda kaschid bhagavans chikirsitam
Naveda kaschid bhagavans chikirsitam
Tave hamanasya Tave hamanasya Nirinam Nirinam Vidambanam
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 Tave hamanasya nirinam vidambanam
Tave hamanasya nirinam
vidambanam Tave hamanasya nirinam vidambanam
Tave hamanasya nirinam vidambanam
Nayasya
Nayasya
Kaschid
Kaschid
Daitosti
Daitosti
Karichid
Karichid
Nayashya Kaschid Daitosti Karichid
Nayashya Kaschid Daitosti Karichid
Nayashya Kaschid Daitosti Karichid Dveshyascha
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 Yasmin
Yasmin
Vishama
Vishama
Matir
Matir
Nrinam
Nrinam
Dveshyascha Yasmin Vishama Drinam Drinam. Dveshyascha Yasmin Vishama Matir Drinam. Naveda kaschid bhagavams chikirshitam.
Naveda kaschid bhagavams chikirshitam.
Naveda kaschid bhagavams chikirshitam.
Naveda kaschid bhagavams chikirshitam.
Tave hamanashya nirinam vidambanam.
Tave hamanashya nirinam vidambanam.
Tave hamanashya nirinam vidambanam.
Tave hamanashya nirinam vidambanam.
Nayashya kaschid daitos di karichid.
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 Dveshyascha yasmin Vishama Matir Nrinam.
Vishyascha Yasmin
Vishama Matir Nrinam. Dveshyascha Yasmin Vishama Matir Nrinam.
Dveshyascha Yasmin
Vishama Matir Nrinam. Naveda kaschid bhagavams chikirshitam.
Naveda kaschid bhagavams chikirshitam.
Tave hamanashya nrinam vidambanam.
Tave hamanashya nrinam vidambanam.
Nayashya kaschid daitos dikarichit.
Nayashya kaschid daitos dikarichit.
Dveshyascha yasmin vishama matir nrinam.
Dveshyascha yasmin vishama matir nrinam.
Naveda kaschid bhagavams chikirshitam.
Naveda kaschid bhagavams chikirshitam.
Tave hamanashya nirinam vidambanam.
Tave hamanashya nirinam vidambanam.
Nayashya kaschid daitos dikarichit.
Nayashya kaschid daitos dikarichit.
Dveshyascha yasmin vishama matir nrinam.
Dveshyascha yasmin vishama matir nrinam.
Shama, shama.
Naveda kaschid bhagavams chikirshitam.
Naveda kaschid bhagavams chikirshitam.
Tave hamanashya nrinam vidambanam.
Tave hamanashya nrinam vidambanam.
Nayashya kaschid daitos dikarichit.
Nayashya kaschid daitos dikarichit.
Dveshyascha yasmin vishama matir nrinam.
Dveshyascha yasmin vishama matir nrinam.
Chintamani Radha. Naveda
Rinam.
Dvesha chayasmin vishama kirinam. Madhava.
La veta kachi bhagavats chi kir sitam.
Na veda kashche bhagavans chikirsham
Taveha manashayinam viktam phalam
Taveha manashayinam vidam phalam
Nayasya kashche daitosi kahichin
Nayasya kashche daitosi harichin
现在我们来看一下译文。主啊，没人能理解您超然的逍遥时光，他们看似人类所为，因此使人误解。您不偏袒谁，也不嫉妒谁，人们只是凭猜测认为您偏心。
Om Jnana Timarandasya Jnanjana Shalakaya Chatsurumilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Tadamayam Tadati SwapadantikamBandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sakrajatam Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sachevam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya DevamShri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakha Nitamscha Hey Krishna Karna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta NamostateTapta Kanchana Gaurange Radhe Vrindavanishwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vanchakaupatarubhyasya Kripa Sindhubhaye Vacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo VaishnavibhyoNamaom Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shrimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Sarasati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha ShunyavadiPaschatya Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare HareHare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Queen Kunti is offering her prayers to Lord Krishna, and she's describing how Lord Krishna's pastimes are very bewildering.
Kunti 王后向主 Krishna 献上的这段祈祷文，他在描述着 Krishna 的逍遥时光是让人觉得非常的困惑。
Kunti describes that Lord Krishna's pastimes that they appear to be human. In some ways they appear like an ordinary person. ButShe knows that Krishna is not an ordinary person.
Kunti 皇后啊，她说到 ，Krishna 所从事的这些逍遥时光，从事的这些活动啊，看起来很像是普通人类的行为，很像普通人。可是 Kunti 皇后她知道 ，Krishna 根本不是一个普通人。
Krishna appears like an ordinary person because he appears to take birth. He has a mother and he has a father.
为什么昆蒂皇后就是说到 Krishna, 一般人就觉得很困惑，看起来 Krishna 像是个普通人，他也要经过出生，而且他有他的父母，看起来很像普通人。
But Kunti knows that Krishna is not just an ordinary child, that he is the Supreme Absolute Truth.
可是昆蒂皇后她非常的清楚，Krishna 他根本不是一个普通的小孩，他是至尊，绝对真理。
He is coming in the form as an ordinary person, but actually he is the origin of everyone and everything.
他只不过是以一个小孩的样子，普通小孩的样子来显现他自己，但是 Krishna 他是万源之源，他是所有的一切存在的原因。
In other words, he is God.
换句话说，他是神。
The God, that person who everything comes from, everything comes from him. He is the one who's there before everything is created. He's there.
Krishna, 他是所有一切创造的根源，他是神。在所有的一切显现之前，它其实就存在了，所以我们才说它是一切存在的原因的起因。
And he's not alone when he's before the creation, before this world comes about. Krishna is there, and he's with all of his associates in the spiritual world.
而且 Krishna, 他不但是在所有的一切创造之前他就已经存在了，而且他在灵性的世界他不是孤单的，他还有着他那么多的美好的同友。
So it's very confusing for people because they see Krishna appearing like a little child and they see him eating the butter.And they see him crying and rubbing his eyes.、
Oh. 对，可是 Krishna 真的让人家觉得很困惑，奇怪他怎么会以那个 baby 的形象来显现，而且他还偷吃奶油，而且他还哭，对不对？然后还揉眼睛，就哭得很伤心那个样子。
Mother Yashoda is chasing him.And he's running and crying.
Yashoda 妈妈就追着他，要处罚他，然后他还跑着，好像很害怕的样子。
His mother's holding a big stick, and Krishna shouting, "Jai Ming, Jai Ming!"
妈妈在后面用棍子，知道吗？要追赶他，他就一直跑，一直跑，救命啊，救命！他还喊救命。
So Krishna is playing the part like a child.
所以。Krishna 就扮演着好像这个孩子的角色。
But actually, he's the original personality of Godhead. He's the Supreme Lord.
但是他是最原初的至尊人格首神他是至尊主。
And he enjoys coming in this form as a child to have loving dealings with his devotees.
他非常享受以孩子的形象到来，因为这样子他就可以跟他挚爱的奉献者从事各种爱的交流的这样的逍遥时光。
So Lord Krishna enjoys exchanges with his devotees.
所以我们要了解 Krishna 至尊人格首神，他非常的喜欢跟他的奉献者进行爱的交流。
He enjoys being a little child and growing up and having the,getting the love from his mother and father.
他很享受作为一个普通的小孩 他就是小时候他跟他的爸爸妈妈就是从事了很多父母跟孩子之间的那种爱的那种甜美的交流他很享受这样的这种童年的逍遥时光长大这样子。
People enjoy married life. They enjoy having a family, having a child. It's pleasure for the mother and father.
我们知道就是在家庭的生活中那个孩子那个甜美可爱的模样真的给他的父母带来了很多甜美的这个回忆所以其实那种是带来很多的喜乐孩子的样子会给父母带来很多的喜乐所以 Krishna 就以这个方式来跟他的奉献者他的父母从事这个爱的交流
Yeah, the mother and father are enjoying the child is also enjoying He's enjoying the love, the affection which is being given to him.
Affection.
Yes.
所以就是父母很享受有这么可爱的 baby, 然后那个 baby Krishna 也非常享受他父母跟他之间给他的那种爱。所以他们彼此之间 ,Krishna 跟他的父母也就是他的奉献者彼此之间那种相互的强烈的爱的吸引非常甜美
So this is confusing, it's bewildering for people. How could it be that Krishna is, that he's got a mother and father, and he's a child? How could this be? That he's supposed to be God, and he's playing the part of a child?
所以一般人听到这种逍遥时光，真的都会感觉到很困惑。那个小孩有可能是神吗？他怎么会扮演一个普通的孩子的角色？看起来就像一个普通的孩子，然后还需要他的爸爸妈妈来照顾他，那种爱的那种交流，看起来很像是普通的那种活动。
I was distributing books one time in Malaysia, and this man said to me, I know Krishna cannot be God.He has a mother and father. He takes birth, so he cannot be God.
有一次我在马来西亚，就有一个人告诉我 ，Krishna 绝对不可能是神。他就告诉我这样子，因为他说，他如果是神的话，他怎么会就是是需要这个普通的父母，好像跟一般的孩子一样，需要有普通的父母而被生下来。怎么会有这种出生的这种事情呢
？And then he said to me, Shiva is God. God is light. Shiva is God.
他说 Shiva 啊才是神啊，所以神是光。
Yes. Light.
Light.
Yes. He said, God is light.
神是光。
I said, Where did the light come from?
那我就问他说。那光是来自哪里
？Don't ask questions.
不要问我问题，不要问我这个问题。
Just listen to what I. So they had no answer. Of course, any intelligent person will want to know where did the light come from.
对他们其实害怕问问题，因为再想下去他就被打败了。所以这个，然后可是事实上，一个聪明的人，他应该懂得去询问。如果他们认为就是源头是光，那光是来自哪里呢
？Just like we have light here in this room, where does the light come from? Oh, it comes from the light bulb. But where does the power for the light come from? Oh, it comes from the power station. There's a power station generating electricity.
比方说我们看到，哎，这里怎么有灯光？然后人们就问说，哎，灯是这个光是从哪里来？人们就说从灯泡来啊，啊，灯泡从灯泡的电从那个哪里来？他说从电台来的。
And in the power station, there's engineers there who are arranging for the electricity to be generated.
那如果这个电呢是从那个电台。那个发电厂，那么总是有一个工程师，对不对？他们必须安排这所有的一切呀、啊。他不会是突然就有了这个发电厂，突然有了 灯泡，不是，这一切都有原因的。
There are people responsible for everything.
总是背后有一个人在那里安排着所有的一切。
In the same way, everything which we see in this world, it has its origin, comes from someone.
同样的，我们在这个三千大千世界，我们所看到的那种千变万化的种种物质的事物，其实都是来自于，总是有源头，它不会突然就有这么多的东西存在。
And we're saying everything comes from Krishna.
那而因此我们知道，我们说所有的一切都是来自于那个源头 Krishna.
So he appears to be human. We see him, we see the pictures, right? Here's Krishna.He's playing the flute. He's a young man.
那我们就觉得 Krishna 怎么是一个看起来像个普通人呢？你看他这个图画上 ，Krishna 就是一个年轻的少男，然后他吹着笛子。
So he looks human.
Huh?
He's looking human. He has two hands. He has two eyes.He has two ears, he has one head, he has two legs, he looks like a human.
看一下，就觉得 Krishna, 他根本就是普通人啊，他跟我们一样啊，有两只眼睛，一个嘴巴，两只耳朵，对不对？眉毛，头发，他的四肢，双手，双腿，你看他那个样子，那不就是人吗？人的形象不就是这样吗？
So Krishna has a body, but his body is not like our body.
Krishna, 我们有看到他有身体，但是他的身体跟我们不一样，他是灵性的身体。
Our body is blood and bones and unpleasant things, you know.
但是我们的这个物质身体，它不一样，就是一个臭皮囊。我们知道是血肉之躯，就是你看我们的血肉之躯 包覆着那些让人觉得很不愉悦的东西，把它打开来就知道是不愉悦的东西。
They have within the body their organs, you know, you have things like a heart, you have liver, you have glands, yeah, they're all horrible looking things.
不然把这个皮肉把它打开之后就知道里面有，其实是很可怕的，有各种器官，心脏啊，肺啊，肝脏啊，这些什么的，各种器官都在里面。
In the same way, Lord Krishna, he also has a body, but his body is spiritual. It's not, our body is material. It's made with blood and bones, these things. But Krishna's body is fully spiritual. It's sat.Chit Ananda, eternal, full of bliss and knowledge.
所以我们要了解 Krishna 的身体，它是灵性的，它不是物质的身体。我们确实是臭皮囊、血肉之躯，可是 Krishna 他的身体是全然的灵性的身体，它是由 Sat.Chi Ananda 所组成的，所以他的身体是永恒，而且是全知，而且是极乐所组成的身体。
Lord Krishna came in this world. He stayed in this world more than 100 years, but he didn't get old. He was always a young man.
当 Krishna 在这个物质世界显现的时候啊。他其实停留了100多年的时间，但是啊，尽管100多年，你想想看，100多岁的人是怎么样？可是他却永远的青春年少，风华正茂。
He didn't have to worry about the hair falling out or going gray, or he didn't have to worry about the old age because his body is spiritual. It doesn't grow old.
因为 Krishna 的身体是灵性的，所以他永远都不用担心他会经历生老病死之苦， 他也不用担心哦，自己会变老，没有这一回事。嗯。
If you go to the spiritual world, there's a spiritual world. There's another world beyond this world. We're in the material world, a place of birth and death. But there's another world beyond this world where everyone enjoys eternal life.
嗯，当我们讲到灵性世界，我们要了解真的有这样的一个地方，那个地方是超越生死的地方，不像我们在这个物质世界，无论如何我们总是要经历这种生老病死之苦，但是灵性世界没有这一回事。
In the spiritual world, there's no old age.
灵性世界没有年老。
There's no disease.
没有疾病。
There's no COVID.
没有新冠。
Right? There's none of, no cancer.
没有癌症。
Everyone enjoys eternal life without growing old.
所以在灵性世界，所有的人他们都享受着这种永生，都不用担心自己所谓的死亡或者变老，这些没有这种焦虑。
And so Lord Krishna comes into this world to perform his pastimes, his activities, to enjoy some games with his devotees and to attract all of us to go back with him to the spiritual world.
所以 Krishna 来到这里显现，写他的显现其实他是想跟他的奉献者从事一些逍遥时光，因为 Krishna 的活动非常吸引人，他想要借由跟我们奉献者从事这些逍遥时光，把我们吸引带回灵性世界，吸引我们。
What is it like there in the spiritual world?
灵性世界是什么样子啊？
This photo is like a window into the spiritual world.
其实一幅画胜过千言万语，我们看到这样的一幅画，就看感受到那个是通往灵性世界的窗口。
Within the spiritual world, it's a beautiful place. With nature, you can enjoy nature. You can see the lotus flowers growing. You can see everywhere flowers and the trees are blooming with fruits and flowers.
You mean in the spiritual world?
Yes.
Maharaj 在描述我们就看到这个画面里面可以 了解在灵性世界所有的一切是那么的美丽，那么的祥和就整个在大自然的包围中这种百花齐放那么美那么多的这种大自然的绽放的一切的姹紫嫣红百花齐放。
There's no overpopulation.
到那里也没有所谓的就是人口过剩的问题。
Actually, there's no overpopulation here either.
其实我们的地球也没有所谓的就是人口就是过剩的问题，过度拥挤的问题。
We see everywhere there's so much land where there are no people. There's everywhere there's land, open land.
Yeah, 其实我们看到，其实我们说人口过剩，可是还是有很多的地方是空地的。
But people worry, oh, there's too many people.
可是人们总是很担心，哦，人口过剩太可怕了。
Problem is everybody's moving into the one place. We all come to live in the cities.
因为人们是这样的，全部的人都拥挤到，都挤到城市里来，所以这个地方会有种感觉是非常的拥挤。可是还有那么多地方可以住，可是人们不喜欢，全部都涌进了都市。
We come and live in the city, and we live on top of each other, right? We build buildings.
那大家都住到城市里怎么办呢？就没有所谓的平房了，对不对？就是大楼，就是高楼林立，是吗？一层一层的，所以每个人都在我们的楼上，有没有？一层一层上去都是高楼，所以我们楼上都有住人，对。所以马尔才讲，别人都在我们的头上。
So Lord Krishna performs interesting activities. And it's said that Lord Krishna is not partial to anyone. He's equal to everyone.
Mm. 所以 Krishna 他从事的很多很有趣很有趣的逍遥时光。那么在这些诗中 Kunti 皇后也讲到、Krishna 他对待所有的生物生命都是平等的，他并不偏袒谁。
But that is also confusing because we see Lord Krishna kills the demons. Now if he's equal to everyone, why is he killing the demons and being kind to his devotees? Isn't that partiality?
嗯，可是我们还是听到这个觉得很困惑。你说 Krishna 不偏袒任何人是真的吗？那为什么他杀死恶魔，然后他保护他的奉献者？那不就看到 Krishna 是偏袒的吗？他偏袒他的奉献者。
If Krishna is not partial, if he's equal to everyone, then why does he kill the demons? Shouldn't he be kind to the demons?
对，如果说 Krishna 是平等对待所有的生命，他不偏袒任何人的话，那么为什么 Krishna 还杀死恶魔？他应该同样的对待恶魔，也是像对待奉献者一样的平等才对啊。
But we should understand that the demons which are killed by Krishna are also not ordinary. And when they are killed by Krishna, then they are liberated and they go to the spiritual world.
嗯，首先我们要了解一件事情，被 Krishna 杀死的恶魔其实根本就不是普通人。而 Krishna 亲手杀死的恶魔，他立刻得到解脱，因为他被净化了，所以他是上升到灵性世界。
So Krishna is kind to everyone. He gives everyone an equal opportunity.
所以 Krishna 仁慈平等的对待众生，他给每一个生命同等的机会。
He's giving mercy.To everyone who wants it, do we want the mercy of Krishna?
嗯，他平等的把他的仁慈给予所有的生命。好，所以 Maharaj 说，大家想要得到 Krishna 的仁慈吗？
Just like the sun is shining on everyone's head.
就像阳光普照，它洒落在每个人的头上。
The sun is there every day in the sky.And it's lighting up the world. But the owl, there's a bird called the owl, which only opens its eyes in the night. In the daytime, its eyes are closed. So when all the other animals in the forest are talking about the sun, that, oh, the sun was so hot today, the owl will say, I never saw any sun.
Okay. 那我们知道所谓的阳光、遍洒大地，这是我们都知道的，它是平等的给予所有的生命。可是有一种动物叫做猫头鹰，猫头鹰只有在晚上的时候才会睁开它的双眼，对，然后就有那个动物啊，他们就在窃窃私语，就在讲说，哦，那个阳光啊，知道吗？很晒啊、烈日。知道吗？当空，他们觉得哦，好热啊，炙热难耐。然后那个猫头鹰就说什么：“我怎么不知道？我怎么不知道什么太阳？我从来都没有见过啊、从来都没有感受过什么叫做太阳，阳光，
The sun was there for everyone, but the owl did not open the eyes.
阳光、太阳始终都在。”可是因为猫头鹰它始终在白天的时候从来都没有张开它的眼睛过，所以它根本就不知道那是什么。
In the same way, some people are blind to the pastimes of Krishna.
同样的，有些人呢，他们对于 Krishna 从事的逍遥时光，他们是等于是他们目盲，他们看不见，他们不知道 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
They don't see the transcendental nature of Lord Krishna.
他们看不见 Krishna 他的这个活动的超然本质。
But the devotees, they can see, they understand Krishna.
但是奉献者看得到，奉献者能够明白 Krishna 他的这种超然的逍遥时光
and,
这种本质。
And Kunti, she can understand Krishna's.Nature.
昆提王后、哦、她、哦、想必是一定是可以了解 Krishna 的超然的逍遥时光她的本质的、
So, Krishna says himself that he is not manifest to the foolish and the unintelligent.
Krishna 说过我永不向愚蠢的人揭示我自己
He said, "For them, I am covered by yoga maya."
他说，对他们，我用 yoga maya 遮住我自己，不向他们揭示我自己。
Yoga maya is the covering the it's an energy of Krishna which covers up Krishna to hide him from the foolish people.
嗯，那 yoga maya 是 Krishna 的这种内在能量。他用 Yoga Maya 遮住他自己 不像愚蠢的人随便揭示展示他自己
So the devotees they understand they, they can recognize Krishna
可是奉献者却有那样的慧眼他们能够辨识得出 Krishna
But there are people who will never surrender to Krishna
可是有些人却永不向 Krishna 臣服。
They will say, "No, no, I have to work. I have to work."
有的人会说，不不不，我有工作要做。
I have to earn money, make money. I have to eat. I have to earn money.
我必须吃东西，所以我必须要赚钱。我必须要好好的赚钱。
We tell them, "Come and chant Hare Krishna for a little while."
我们邀请他们说来吧我们一起念诵 Hare Krishna 念诵一会儿吧
Come and take some nice prasadam
来跟我们一起荣耀一点 prasadam 吧
But they will say no no I have to work I have to work
那他们就会说哦不不我必须要工作我不能去、
So they're unfortunate
所以很不幸就是有一些人他们没有办法
They just want to spend their time their whole lifeJust to work.
他们穷其一生、都在奋力的工作。
And they don't take any time to hear about Krishna.
他们没有什么机会，没有什么时间可以聆听到关于 Krishna 的一切。
And they never ask, they never inquire about life. Why am I here?
而且他们也不询问生命的问题，从来都不问这样的问题：我为什么来到此？到底是为了什么？我生命。的生命到底是发生了什么状况？我为什么来到这里？
They won't ask questions. They will just only want to work, to solve the problems, to eat and sleep.
一般的人只想奋力的工作，只想解决他们生存的问题，关于吃啊、睡啊等等方面的问题。
So Krishna comes into this world to perform his activities.To give pleasure to devotees and to free the demons, to take the demons out.
所以、Krishna 他从事他这些喜乐的逍遥时光、是来解救他的奉献者、并且铲除一些恶魔。
The devotees, they enjoy the activities of Krishna.
奉献者非常享受 Krishna 所从事的逍遥时光。
And the demons, they envy Krishna.
可是敌人却仇视嫉妒 Krishna.
And sometimes they want to even try to kill Krishna.
甚至恶魔会想杀死 Krishna.
But they end up being killed themselves.
可是最后他们却被 Krishna 干掉了。
But that killing, when Krishna kills, that is mercy. They are liberated. They go back to the spiritual world.
可是被 Krishna 杀死却是一件受到祝福的事被 Krishna 杀死的人得到解脱回到灵性世界去了
And so in this way Krishna is kind to everyone
所以我们说 Krishna 他其实对所有的生命都是很仁慈的。
He's always kind to his devotees. It's a special kindness to his devotees.
他特别的就是对待他的奉献者特别的仁慈。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, for one who surrenders fully to him, he says, I carry what they lack, and I preserve what they have.
Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中他这样子告诉我们，对于一个全新的就是在这个奉爱的道路上为我做服务的人，他拥有什么我就替他保存什么，他缺少什么我就给他什么。
So material life, we're very worried about lacking something. There are many things we lack which we would need.
其实我们在物质生存中我们都充满了恐惧，我们在恐惧什么？我们有一种匮乏感，我们很害怕我们没有这个没有那个，所以我们很没有安全感。
Maybe I don't have enough intelligence.
也许我智力不够。
I don't have the shakti, I don't have the power.
我没有力量。
But Krishna will take care.
但是不要担心啊，那些为 Krishna 做奉爱服务的人，Krishna 说我会亲自来照顾这样的人。
And whatever we have, we may worry about losing what we have.
对，一旦我们拥有了什么，接着我们还会很恐惧，拥有的东西也会害怕再失去。
I may lose my good health, I may lose my family, I may lose my wealth. Krishna said, no, no, I will take care, I will preserve.
所以人们也会很担心我会不会失去我的财富？我会不会失去我的健康？我会不会失去我的家人？不要担心，不要担心。Krishna 说你拥有什么 ？Krishna 会保护你就是保护你，让你就是让你拥有那些东西，不会让它失去，替你保有这个东西。
And we see a nice example how Krishna maintained what people have.Just like his mother, Krishna's mother, when Krishna took his birth, before his birth, his mother had given birth to five children who had all been killed, or six children who had all been killed by cruel Kamsa.
那我来 Maharaj 来给大家讲一个故事，来让我们了解这个道理就在那个 Krishna 显现之前呢，很残酷的这个恶魔 Kamsa， 他杀死了之前的他的妈妈之前的六个孩子，都被恶魔一个一个杀死了。
So his mother asked Krishna, Lord Krishna, she understood Krishna was not an ordinary person. She requested, "Can you bring your brothers back to life?"
所以他的妈妈知道。Krishna 不是一个普通人，所以他就要求 Krishna， 你可不可以把我失去的那个六个孩子帮我找回来？
So Krishna went to Yamalok and he brought back the six children. They brought them to his mother.
Krishna 后来真的到了 Yamaloka， 知道吗？去把这个他的妈妈在他之前 生下的那六个孩子被杀死的孩子，从 Yamaloka。把他带回来了。
Krishna brought them back to his mother, and his mother could feed her breast milk to them. She was so happy. She got all of her children back. And then the children went to heaven.
So you say when mama see the children, she's very happy and kiss them also. What did you say?
Breast them.
Okay. 然后结果这六个。孩子被带回来了，你知道吗？结果因为那个妈妈失去了那个孩子，真的看到孩子的时候真的喜极而泣，很开心，她还亲自喂奶给他们。后来这六个孩子啊，他们都到了天堂去了。因为 Krishna 的妈妈的奶是 prasada， 所以都
Krishna drank that milk。
因为 Krishna 是不是喝他妈妈的奶？
The other brothers were coming and they were also drinking the milk.
懂意思吗？因为他妈妈的奶 Krishna 喝过了，对不对？所以剩下的其他的奶就是 Prasada。 所以他的其他的哥哥们喝到了妈妈的奶之后，他们都得到 Prasada， 所以都到天堂星球去了。
So this was all Krishna's mercy。
还好我有问这个，所以这真的是 Krishna 的仁慈啊。
You don't have to worry about anything。
所以不用担心什么。嗯，
Okay, any question?
有没有什么问题？其实我们这个，
那Maharaj有一个问题，就是我们灵魂啊，灵魂个体灵魂在灵性世界也有它个体的形体吗？
Yes, you have a form.
那个形体是什么样的形体？就是。
好，现在那个 Madhava Mohini 他问了 Maharaj 一个问题，他说在灵性世界我们个体生命也有他的形象吗？那 Maharaj 说有的。
Yes, we have a form, and that form will depend on our rasa with Krishna, what position we take in the spiritual world, what rasa we have.
那这个形体是根据什么而有的呢？根据我们的地位还有我们的 rasa， 我们跟 Krishna 的一种关系，所以我们就会得到某一种，就是那种灵性的身体。
Then it will be in the five rasa, one of the five rasas, right?
不是有五种跟 Krishna 的关系吗？对不对？不同的关系，所以就会有不同的形象跟 Krishna 进行这些 rasa 爱的交流啊。
And we can take any form we like when we go there to the spiritual world, according to our desire, how we want to serve Krishna.
根据我们想要以某一种方式来服务 Krishna， 每一个生命都有他的愿望，那么我们就会得到某一种特定的形象。
Maybe you'd like to be the flower.
也许你会变成一朵花。
Flowers are eternal in the spiritual.
可是不要担心，花儿在灵性世界不会枯萎凋落，好凋谢，它是一朵永恒的花。
所以，不管是扮演什么样形体，在灵性世界一定都跟 Krishna 有一个互动的关系。
互动就是 interaction。
Yes.
任何的。Any living entity has a kind of relationship or interaction with Krishna in the spiritual world?
Yes.
是的，对。
可是 Krishna 只有一个，然后我们个体灵魂那么多，他怎么可能跟每一个
？But Krishna has many expansions.
可是不要忘了 ，Krishna 他是无限的，他可以同时存在，知道吗
？Just like he had 16,000 wives.
不要忘了 ，Krishna 他同时可以娶了16,000。知道吗？个妻子，他同时跟他们在一起。
And Krishna was with each of the wives.
哈
？He was at the same time. He was with.
他同时跟16,000个妻子同时在一起。
So you don't have to worry.
Don't have to worry.
不用担心。
不用担心 ，worry 哈。不用担心。
Krishna is in the heart of every living entity.
Krishna 在每个生物体的心中陪伴着我们。
Right, he is giving us knowledge, remembrance or forgetfulness.
Krishna 赐予给我们知识、记忆和遗忘，对不对？这些都是来自于 Krishna 给予我们的。
Just think how busy Krishna is.
可以想象 Krishna 有 很多忙啊。
Within the heart of every living entity，
他在每一个生物体的心中，哎，他知道所有的一切。
那 Maharaj 还有另外一个问题，就是昨天呢，我有碰到一个民众啊，然后跟他聊天，然后他就说，他只要他就是他身体他很特殊，就是他只要一听到一些特殊的音乐。
可是他们在录音啊，
在录音，所以需要给其他的人知道你在问什么，马上回答，他们才不会
过来就好，
不会说不了解。
两道镜头。
就是我昨天碰到一位民众啊，然后他就说他的身体就是听到一些特殊的音乐，然后就会起一些像灵动之类的。对，然后我就好奇，我就想要知道说，像这样子的人，他就觉得说他处在一种已经很特殊的一种对一种灵性的，就是灵性的体验了。那我们怎么样去把他从他的那种概念里面去把他引导到成 Krishna 知觉的概念？
Maharaj, you know what he said? Yesterday we went for Harinam and an audience, and he asked about this question, and she said, you know, she has a special experience about psychic experience whenever he listens to a certain kind of music. And so Madhava Mohini would like to know how to guide such kind of person into a spiritual field.
They have to be willing to take up the practice. They have to be willing to hear. 首先
是要他个人有这种意愿。他如果有这个意愿，真的想要真的去做一些灵性的练习，那么他才有可能有所谓的体验我们的练习所带来的好处。
It begins with hearing.
所以他一开始他是必须要透过聆听。
He has to be willing to hear hear about Krishna.
他必须要能够帮助他去聆听关于 Krishna.
He has to be willing to chant. We teach people also how to chant.
所以我们还是要教他怎么去念诵圣名。
And so you want to bring him to Krishna consciousness. It begins with hearing. Somebody's asleep, how to wake them up, you know, we call into their ear, wake up, you know. So we call Krishna, Krishna, we chant the holy name and we request them to chant.
所以就是要帮助他们从这个幻象中醒过来，他就是要需要唤醒。那个我们念诵 Hare Krishna, 其实它就是一种唤醒 的程序。所以醒来吧，醒来吧！我们每呼喊一声 Hare Krishna, 我们就是在帮助那个灵魂，沉睡的灵魂苏醒过来。所以我们无论如何，就是要让他们，就是你让他们知道，你就是按照这个方法，你试试看，你练习看看，跟其他的经验有什么不一样？
We know the process. It's up to that person how much he wants to follow.
我们可能会让人们了解我们的程序，可是我们也必须要尊重他们的意愿。他们想要，知道吗？用这个方法，那是还是要取决于他们愿不愿意去试试看，他们愿意接受到什么程度。
We can bring the horse to water, but you cannot make it drink. There's a saying in English.
Yeah,
you can bring the horse to water.
Horse, 马。
对，我们可以把马牵到河边，可是我们没有办法强迫它喝水，对不对？对。
So we bring people and we let them hear the holy name, teach them, give them prasada, encourage them.Chant, it's up to them how much they want to follow.
我们可能可以提供给人们各种机会，让他们可以接触到圣名，接触到吃到 prasadam。可是他们至于他们愿意相信接受到什么程度，那还是取决于他。我们没有办法强迫任何一个人。
Yes.
Rasika 有问题，好来。
Maharaj, 我的问题我分两个部分，第一个就是刚才 Maharaj 说，主 Krishna 给出了仁慈，跟接收者有关系， 那这个接收者是指说他接受或者是不接受嘛，哈，这个是最大原因。也就是说每个人他有个体性的关系，所以就看这个人，因为他有个体性嘛，所以看他接受或者是不接受。接受的话他就得到这个仁慈，不接受就是得不到这个仁慈，是这样子吗？这是第一个问题。
是的， it's like that, yes.
是的，是这样子的，嗯。
Yes, some people take the mercy and some people don't.
嗯，有的人他会得到了敞开的心，是敞开的，得到了仁慈，可是有的人他就比较接受不到。
Everyone has free will.
每个人都有他的自由意志。
Do you want to be with Krishna or do you want to be with Maya?
我们每个人都可以选择，我想要跟 Krishna 在一起，还是我想要跟 Maya, 也就是错觉、幻觉能量在一起。
Do you want to serve Krishna or do you want to serve Maya?
你想要服务 Krishna 还是去服务Maya, 错觉能量。
We're always a servant.
我们无论如何我们都是仆人。
It's up to us to choose where we want to serve.
可是我们却取决于我们自己，我们要去服务的那个主人是谁。我们也可以服务 Maya, 也可以服务 Krishna.
So everybody has that free will.
每个人都有他的自由意志，可以去做出这样的选择。
第二个问题就是说，既然是我无缘的仁慈嘛，无缘的仁慈表示说大家都是没有这个资格得到仁慈的，但是我们得到这个无缘的仁慈，那既然是得到仁慈，为什么还要看说这个人接不接受呢？
为什么？
He says, since we say cause this mercy, that means, you know, no matter you are qualified or not qualified, everybody can get mercy. So that means cause this mercy. But why, you know, we still say it depends on if someone want to be the good recipient or not. Someone want to receive, then they can get mercy.For those they don't want to receive, they cannot get mercy. Since it's causeless mercy, how come? Maharaj 刚刚其实已经有回答这个问题了。你有没有？Maharaj 刚刚有讲那个猫头鹰 的事情，还有那个太阳遍洒大地，有没有？好，遍洒大地，那是我们自己的意愿， Krishna 不会强迫我们，有没有？明白吗？
我知道，但是我的问题就是说，那既然是要给出无缘的仁慈嘛，就是。没有缘由的仁慈嘛，为什么还要看这个人接受不接受呢？他愿不愿意？
可是他还是有给啊。阳光遍洒大地的意思就是说他还是有给，他并没有分说这里是沙漠我就不给，这里是森林我给，都给，所以那个就是无缘的仁慈。可是至于我们能不能接收得到，是我们个人。我们要躲在山洞里还是要出来，你明白这个意思吗？所以是我们，可是他的仁慈是无缘的，没有错，因为他没有分你是什么样的资格，我给跟不给。阳光遍洒大地， Maharaj 刚刚其实有讲这个部分。
Sometimes you know if you go out in the street and you say diamonds free, who wants to take diamonds free?
比方说就是有人在卖这个钻石的人，他说好，现在来个大放送，我现在钻石全部都免费大放送。
So people will think, I don't believe it, no.
有的人就想，我不相信，真的，那是假的吧，怎么可能免费的钻石，我才不相信呢。
Somebody else comes, they say, okay, give me some, let me have.
而相信的人他来拿，他真的拿到免费的钻石。
But other people, no, must be some catch.
也有的人就很怀疑，真的吗？那是假的嘛？那是骗人的。
So the same way we try to give mercy, people, you know, no, I don't want the mercy.
所以我们奉献者也试着都想要把 Krishna 的仁慈无缘的仁慈派发出去，可是有的人他就是选择不相信啊，不要不要，我不相信。
Sometimes the lady will go home, she'll bring the prasadam home to, and she'll tell the husband, I brought you some prasadam. And they will say, I don't want to get purified.
有些太太啊，奉献者啊，就带了prasadam回去要给先生吃，知道吗？他就很开心，你知道吗？拿了prasadam，我给你带了prasadam回来，先生就说，我不要，我不要prasadam，我不想被净化。
Not everybody wants to get purified.
所以并不是每个人都想得到净化。还有问题吗？好，下去麦一麦大吉来。
我想要问的是说啊，因为我们的时间就是这样子的时间，那如果说要上一些课程跟礼拜天的那个实质上的服务的话，这样子要怎么抉择？
He said, she said, especially, you know, some online course, but actually in, on Sunday, we all have our, you know, specific service to do, to support the temple. So how to make the right decision? Which one is more important?
Well, both are important, you know.
Maharaj said, 其实都很重要。But what if her point is that what is when the time just contradicts?
Yes, well, you have to consider the situation. What is the course, you know? How long is the course? How many times have you, how important is the course?
然后 Maharaj 说他说其实是要考量，好，比方说如果真的有一个课是所谓的就是好课程出来，如果这个课你要先衡量说这课就是会上多久，它对你的重要性有多大，对不对？就是为什么需要去选择这个课，去考量这些因素才来做决定。如果它会冲突到庙里的中心的服务的话。
What course is this? What are you doing on Sunday?
他说你现在在庙里的服务是什么？他很多服务，他的服务很多。She is just curious. She doesn't have such kind of problem because some other devotee, they may be a little bit struggling about this, and they may choose to take the course, but maybe some other people they neglect the temple service, and so she's curious, want to know what to do is the best.
Well, you have to consider how much are you contributing online when you go online? Yeah, what are you doing? If it's just hearing a class, you're just hearing a class, you could hear a recording of the class. You can hear a recording, they can record the class.
Maharaj 说，如果啊，就是说万一啦，你这个课当下你是确实是对你是蛮重要的课，然后刚好又冲突到服务的时候，他说其实你也可以选择听录音，就是因为既然是线上本来就是听声音而已，对。然后今天其实也有 Maharaj 也有建议，就是说我们的庙那个厨房也可以装一个扩音，有些时候大家在做服务的时候其实也可以边听好一些课，就不会让在做饭的奉献者做 prasadam 的奉献者们就错过了一些东西，这也是一个照顾奉献者的方法，对。
So coming to a center, coming to a program is much more live and personal. If you sit at home, you know, you can be in Maya there, although you're online and listening. We have people, you know, sometimes they're sitting at home and they're, you know, they're doing so many other things at the same time, you know, they're.
Maharaj 说，就是实际的亲身的联谊啊，其实是非常的重要的。马尔刚强调这件事，他说我们亲身的联谊，在这个联谊服务的过程里头，我们会比较当下，我们会真的很感受到那种联谊的那种力量。可是如果我们在家里听课，自己在家里听课，也有可能处在玛雅之中，就是你自己在听家里听课，你也自己不知道听到哪里去，在听什么了。而且有些时候我们在家里听课也不专心，对不对？有些时候在听家里听课的时候，我们还会同时做很多事，边听课其实我们没有真的在听课，同时在做很多事。可是我们在这里听课或者做什么亲身的联谊，那个力量是不一样的。
Yeah, some are at home smoking cigarettes, you know.
有的人搞不好边抽烟边听课，然后
Sometimes it happens.
所以是鼓励，就是说大家多来联谊，亲身的联谊，因为自己一个人的时候比较难控制局势状况了。嗯
嗯。Okay.
嗯。
Anything online?
Yeah. 嗨。好，这边有 Premika Madhaji 哈 ，Hare Krishna Gurudev 曾在一次演讲中说，这些年来他对经文有越来越多的疑问，我可以问他这些问题是什么吗 ？OK, Hare Krishna Gurudev, I once heard that in your lecture, through all these years, you have more and more doubts about the scripture. May I know what are these doubts and questions?
Well, of course, if you read the scriptures more, there will be more questions.
当然，如果我们经典看得越多，我们的问题一定会越多。正常的嘛。
But there are no doubts. I don't have any doubts. I don't know where you got this word doubt from. It's not doubts, which I said, I have questions. I want to know more.
所以Mataji, Maharaj 说问题会越来越多，对不对？你看的越多，一定会有越多的问题。可是马哈拉吉说，不是疑惑，听得懂吗？不是怀疑，不是疑惑，完全是两回事。人有一些问题跟有疑惑是不一样的。
And the more you read the books you're reading, if you're reading regularly, then you will have more questions.
我们越是很规律的研习经典，我们就会发现我们有越多的问题想问，对不对？那但是不是疑惑。好，那现在下一个是 Ananda Radhika Mataji， 亲爱的 Guru Dev， 请接受我谦卑的顶拜。Vipassana 禅修有什么好处吗？那 ISKCON 如何对待它？它可以在 Krishna 知觉中进行吗？所以 Maharaj 你明白他的意思吗？禅修 there is a kind of dhyan. They practice the meditation or yeah, so the, they say vipassana. He say any beneficial from vipassana? 你们听得懂意思哈？禅修有什么好处？这个奉行人问禅修有什么好处，他说我们 ISKCON 是怎么看待的，对待这个部分。我们可以在 Krishna 知觉中进行吗？就是我们在培养 Krishna 知觉的时候，也可以同时禅修吗？禅修就是 Vipassana。
有人可能内观。
观想，
内
观，
观
想。
现在台湾也很多。
对对，就是这个。
内观怎么讲？
他们就是讲 Vipassana。
有 Vipassana 禅思。
对。And also they are practicing how to look within.
Yeah.
我帮你翻译了 look within.
But we have,
向内看。
That is part of the Ashtanga Yoga.
Huh?
That is the Ashtanga Yoga program.
其实这个方法也是所谓的 Ashtanga Yoga 的一部分，八步瑜伽的一部分。
But our process is to always remember Krishna.
但是我们的等一下，马哈里在讲话哈。但是我们的这个程序啊， 我们的程序就是我们在练习哈，分爱的程序就是我们在练习怎么去记得 Krishna。
Yeah, always remember Krishna and never forget him.
永远的记得 Krishna， 永远不要遗忘 Krishna。
So that is our vipassana.
嗯
，Krishna is within.
那么这个就是我们的禅修，明白吗？那就我们的禅修，其实如果以禅修的概念，这种我们的冥想是我们永远想着 Krishna， 永不忘记 Krishna 这样子。
Krishna's within and Krishna's without also is everywhere.
嗯，我们总是无时不在的无所不在的感受到 Krishna 的临在 ，Krishna 在外又在内，所以我们无论是在任何一种情况中，行住坐卧中。不是只有在冥想的时候，知道吗？打坐的时候，我们的活动也是，嗯。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, "For one who sees me everywhere, and sees everything in me, I am never lost to him, nor is he ever lost to me."
Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中讲到，他说：“那一个，他说可以在无所不在的处处都可以看到我的人，哦。”就是他看到我在一切之中，也在一切之外，他无所不在的看到我的人啊，能够感知到我的人。那么这样的人啊，他永远不会失去我，我也永远不会失去他。嗯，这样子可以吗？好，好，接下来有还是 Premika Mataji， 有些资深的奉献者说。随着岁月的流逝，我们应该问越来越少的问题。但是我在 Krishna 知觉中已经很久了，尽管如此，我问的问题却没有减少。为什么会这样呢？
Just more questions.
Yeah, he said that even through all these years practice, I still have a lot of questions. But those senior devotees told me that I should have, you know,fewer and fewer questions through my practice.
Well, I don't agree.
我不同意这种说法。问题不是越来越少。
If you're reading the books regularly, you can have more and more questions.
如果我们很规律的研习经典，我们会发现我们有越来越多的问题想发问。嗯。所以并不是。
Understand more and more.
嗯，因为我们会遇到越来越多的我们不懂的地方，我们会越想去了解。嗯，所以这个好，那下一个问题是谁？我看不懂。
Baba Tarini
是吗？
嗯。
顶拜 Guru Maharaj 和所有的奉献者们，平时看到的图片 ，Krishna 都是穿着夏天的衣服，怎么没见过 Krishna 穿长袖呢？Vrindavan 也有很冷的时候啊。
Well, if you see the deities, we do see the deities in the winter dress. They have long sleeves.
可是我们给神像穿衣服的时候，也会穿长袖的啊。比方说，在冬天冷的时候，我们会为神像穿上长袖的衣服。
And in Vrindavan, they do put special heavier, thicker clothing on the deities in the winter time.
Special high coat, right?
No, heavier.
Heavier, okay. 那冬天很冷的时候，我们还会为神像制作那种，知道吗？很厚的衣服，帮神像保暖。
But usually when the artists are painting, they will paint the pictures Krishna in the summertime.
但是在这个图画中，我们所看到的好像都是展现啊，都是夏日时光哈，夏天的时候 ，Krishna 就是他的样子，他不是穿着冬衣，他不是穿着冬衣。
嗯、mm-hmm. ，OK。
好，那 Nitai， 我这里看不到名字。
Nitai Priya。
Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, is it possible to become non-living things like musical instruments for Krishna's peacock fan
in the spiritual world?
Yeah, 是的，可以的。Yes, no problem.
In the spiritual world, everything is personal.
嗯。好，我还没有把它翻成中文，奉献者们不知道这在问什么。Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj， 有可能可以变成就是没有生命的 哦，不会活动的那种东西吗？在灵性世界可以变成，比方说像乐器，或者是 Krishna 头上的孔雀毛，对。然后 Krishna 那个 Maharaj 说，在灵性世界呀，无论是什么乐器、孔雀毛、花什么，任何的一切石头，反正所有的一切都是有生命的，都是有生命的。Maharaj， 你是说有生命的吗？都是有生命的。
The house, in the house.
房子也是有生命的。
The car.
Car.
A chariot.
他说的是马车。马车也是有生命的。
Okay.
好。他这样子。
Okay.
灵性世界有冬天吗？
有。
有冬天。啊，你没听到？
对啊，灵性世界不是都是
阳光啊？
对啊，都是像这样子呀。
可是为了 Krishna 的 Lila， 是不是可以展现各种不同的变化？
可能
。哎，又来了。
哦，又来
一个。好，顶拜叫 Baba Taruni 是不是？顶拜 Guru Maharaj， 我儿子同学的妈妈很喜欢圣经，我们聊过几次，有一些共识，但他不相信业报，我们都觉得自己是正确的，都想把自己的书分享给对方，我还有必要再花时间和他聊下去吗？是不是可以送他一本《薄伽梵歌》，不需要太多的解释呢？怎么办呢？
对，送给他书。
送给他书。
不用
讲
那么多，
不用解释那么多。他不相信业报。
So how can he explain why somebody is rich and somebody is poor？
如果没有业报的话，怎么去解释？为什么有的人生下来知道吗，他就是含着金汤匙来的，啊，有些人就是出生在很就是贫贱的家庭，然后真的这怎么解释呢？
天主教和基督教不讲业报，
不讲业报，所以马上就说这样怎么解释，就是这个逻辑就不通呢。
同一个家庭小孩子
对也不一样啊，同样一个富贵人家家庭也不一样，
一
对，都不一样，都不一样。对，真的，好像没有问题了哈。好像没有问题了。
OK, very good. So far, okay.
Jai. Jai. 你是 Mahamaraj Ki Jai.Jai， 谢谢 Maharaj Ki， Jai，
谢谢
Jai。